Introduction and classification of herpes viruses. The herpes viruses belong to herpes viridae family. This family consists of more than 100 species, and all those are enveloped DNA viruses, and they have the ability to establish latent infections. So the characteristic property of the species of herpes viridae family is they have the ability to establish latent infections, which causes persistent indefinitely within the infected host, and it also undergoes periodic reactivation. So the infections persist indefinitely within the infected host and they also undergo periodic reactivation. Morphology. This is a structure of herpes simplex virus. It consists of a lipid envelope, and the nucleocapsid consists of DNA core, and the DNA present is linear double-stranded DNA. So this is the linear double-stranded DNA enclosed in a nucleocapsid. The envelope contains spike proteins. So these are the spikes. And the amorphous structure present between the envelope and the nucleocapsid is called the tegment. This portion is the tegment. This tegment contains several proteins. So this is the morphology of herpes simplex virus. Coming to the replication of herpes viruses. The herpes viruses replicate in the host cell nucleus. So they produce intranuclear inclusion bodies called as Cowdrey type A inclusion bodies, also called as Lipschitz bodies. So the herpes virus produce intranuclear inclusion bodies. These are called as Cowdrey type A bodies or Lipschitz bodies. Classification. There are 8 types of herpes viruses, for which the primary hosts are humans. The classification is, the family herpes viridae is classified into 3 subfamilies: alpha herpes viruses, beta herpes viruses, and gamma herpes viruses. Let's see all these 3 one by one in detail. Alpha herpes viruses, they have short replicative cycle, 12 to 18 hours. And they have variable host range, and they cause latent infection in sensory ganglia. Examples of alpha herpes viruses include herpes simplex virus, that is HSV1 and HSV2, herpes simplex virus 1 and 2, and varicella zoster virus, which causes chickenpox, that is human herpes virus 3. Coming to the beta herpes viruses. These beta herpes viruses replicate slowly. They take more than 24 hours for replication, and they have narrow host range, and they grow best in fibroblast, and they produce cytomegaly, that is increase in size of cells, and they cause latent infection in salivary glands and other organs. The example of beta herpes viruses is cytomegalovirus, which is human herpes virus 5. Coming to the gamma herpes viruses, the gamma herpes viruses also have a narrow host range like beta herpes viruses, and these viruses replicate in lymphoblastoid cells. So they are specific for B or T lymphocytes. As they replicate in lymphoblastoid cells, they are specific for B lymphocytes or T lymphocytes. And these gamma herpes viruses produce latent infection in lymphoid tissues. Example for gamma herpes viruses is Epstein-Barr virus, which is human herpes virus 4. So the 3 subfamilies are alpha herpes virus, beta herpes viruses, and gamma herpes viruses. Examples for alpha herpes viruses is herpes simplex virus 1 and 2 and varicella zoster virus, that is human herpes virus 3. Example for beta herpes viruses is cytomegalovirus, which is human herpes virus 5. An example for gamma herpes viruses is Epstein-Barr virus, which is human herpes virus 4. Let's see the broader classification of human herpes viruses, type 1 to 8. First, human herpes virus 1. The common name for it is herpes simplex virus 1. They belong to the subfamily alpha, and the cytopathology is they are cytolytic. They cause lysis of the cells, so they are cytolytic, and the site of latent infection is neurons. So human herpes virus is called as herpes simplex virus 1, belonging to subfamily alpha, is cytolytic, and the site of latent infection is neurons. Next is human herpes virus 2. This is called as herpes simplex virus 2, and this also belongs to the subfamily alpha, and this is also cytolytic. It causes lysis of cells, and the site of latent infection is neurons. Same of HHV1. Next is human herpes virus 3. Human herpes virus 3 is called as varicella zoster virus, which causes chickenpox. This also belongs to the subfamily alpha, and this is also cytolytic, and the site of latent infection is neurons. So all the first three human herpes viruses, that is HSV1, HSV2 and varicella zoster virus, all the three belong to the subfamily alpha, and all those three are cytolytic, and the site of latent infection is neurons. Next is human herpes virus 4, also called as Epstein-Barr virus. This belongs to subfamily gamma, and cytopathology, they are lymphoproliferative, that is they undergo replication in lymphoid tissues, and the site of latent infection is lymphoid tissues. So HHV4 is Epstein-Barr virus, belonging to subfamily gamma. They are lymphoproliferative, and the site of latent infection is lymphoid tissues. Next is human herpes virus 5, called as cytomegalovirus. This belongs to subfamily beta. Cytopathology, this is cytomegalic. That is, it causes increase in size of cells. Cytomegalovirus. The site of latent infection is secretory glands, kidneys and other organs and tissues. So HHV5 is cytomegalovirus, as the name indicates, it causes cytomegaly, belonging to subfamily beta, and the site of latent infection is secretory glands, kidneys, other organs and tissues. Next is human herpes virus 6. This is called as human B cell lymphotrophic virus. Human B cell lymphotrophic virus. This also belongs to subfamily beta as cytomegalovirus. And this is lymphoproliferative, and the site of latent infection is lymphoid tissues. Next, coming to human herpes virus 7, also called as RK virus. This RK virus also belongs to subfamily beta, and they are also lymphoproliferative, and the site of latent infection is lymphoid tissues. And the last is human herpes virus 8. There is no specific name for HHV8, and this belongs to subfamily gamma. The HHV1, 2 and 3, that is HSV1, HSV2 and varicella zoster virus, belong to subfamily alpha. All these three are cytolytic, and the site of latent infection for all these three is neurons. Next, HHV5, HHV6 and HHV7, cytomegalovirus, human B cell lymphotrophic virus and RK virus. All these three belong to subfamily beta, the HHV4, that is Epstein-Barr virus belonging to subfamily gamma, is lymphoproliferative. The same way HHV6 and HHV7 are also lymphoproliferative. So the three lymphoproliferative human herpes viruses are Epstein-Barr virus, human B-cell lymphotrophic virus and RK virus. And the site of latent infection for all these three is lymphoid tissues. So this is about the basic introduction and classification of human herpes virus. Let's see in detail in upcoming videos. Thank you.